The Vrindavan campus completes 50 years of its existence. The glory of Vrindavan Darshans started way back in 1964, and anyone who has seen Swami during that period, they say that the kind of sweetness that you experienced during the Darshans, the kind of closeness that you felt with Bhagwan during that era was something else. And we have today Subramaniam sir, who has had the opportunity to see Swami in the 70s and after that been blessed with the chance to serve in his college for more than 40 years now. So, sir, if you can take us back to those days of Vrindavan, if you remember how it was to see Swami in the 60s, in the 70s, and of course, in the old bungalow days.
Sai Ram, let me tell you a story.
Okay.
You can see the Vrindavan gate?
Yes.
The silver gate? Right outside that, a person was standing, waiting for someone, apparently. A Westerner comes from the Darshan ground, approaches him and asks him, "Sir, can you speak English?"
Okay.
That person to whom he addressed turns out to be the principal of this college and a professor in English.
Okay.
Of Vrindavan College.
Okay.
So he smiled and said, "Yes, I do."
Yes.
The other person said, the foreigner said, "I had the voice inside me told me that I should speak to you."
Okay.
"That's why I came to you." Then this professor, D. Narendra, he says, "Oh, you must be the person Bhagwan Satya Sai Baba said that you'll come to meet me."
Oh, wow.
He said, "You're the lecturer who will come to meet me." Frank Barnowski was frankly taken aback. He said, "How did this man, Baba, knew that I'm a lecturer and I've given more than 9th-year lectures? How did he know?"
Uh-huh.
Oh, there must be something. And that's how the story of the aura begins.
Okay.
He introduces himself as a person, a scientist, who has studied auras. He was gifted with this ability to see auras of every human being, even as a baby, which people around could not understand. They thought it's some witchcraft, or he was possessed or something. So he learned to keep quiet. But after he grew up, he studied, he understood what it was. He started studying this aura in great detail. He also is credited with inventing a camera called Kirillian photograph camera, which can take photographs of auras, human auras. So to cut a long story short, he found that the aura is nothing but a light surrounding a human being, a contour of light.
Yes.
That reflects a mental attitude of a person and also indicates a health of that person. The aura contains a variety of colors. Red indicates anger, which is predominant in many people. good colors, blue indicates deep spirituality.
Wow.
And pink, which is rare, that indicates love.
Mm-hmm.
Not just ordinary love, selfless love.
Pure love.
A person with pink aura is capable of pure love.
Mm-hmm.
And also another two colors, which he mentions, that these are... Now let me, as he was explaining like that, he was told by Bhagwan sent word, Baba sent word, that he should address the students in the evening, talk to the students. So in the evening, there was bhajan in this Kalyan Mandapam. There all the students and teachers were seated. Swami asked Frank Baranowski to speak. So he told all this story and he continued. He said, apart from these two colors, pink and blue, which he found in Baba at a level which he has not found in any human being, 40, 50 feet thick, away from Baba, this pink color. He says, I've gone round the world. I've visited presidents. I've visited great political leaders, great spiritual leaders. I've visited the Pope. So many people I've seen. Never I've seen, in the case of Baba, the aura bounces along with him as he walks.
Oh, wow.
It expands and shrinks.
Uh-huh.
And when he comes for darshan, when he moves round the people, this aura reaches out and goes and envelops each and every one's aura. Not only that, the aura which has various colors, they're all transformed into an aura of pink. That is what darshan means.
Wow.
That's the impact of darshan. Or maybe, what, as I understand, when Baba says, darshan time, when you have darshan, you receive my grace.
Mm.
Probably receiving his grace is receiving that love in that form.
Thank you.
He said there are two other colors which he rarely found, only in extremely great people, and that is gold and silver.
Wow.
In the case of Baba, he says they were few feet thick. Wow. And then he sits down. Then bhajans start. Boys start singing bhajans. And when bhajans go on, they continue till Swami stops the bhajan. Swami stops the bhajan, and then we have aarti. Here we have a person who has just come first. Suddenly he gets up in the middle of the bhajan, goes to Swami, seated there, and tells something to Swami. Mm. Swami says, stop the bhajan. Tells the boy, stop the bhajan. And he gets up to speak. He says, I took Baba's permission to interrupt this. I wanted to tell you that as this bhajan is going on, Baba's aura is expanding, enveloping each and every one with that love.
Wow.
In fact, I think he made this momentous statement. First time I think we have heard that. Baba is love walking on 2 feet.
On 2 feet.
Love walking on 2 feet.
Wow.
He was so overwhelmed.
Amazing.
He has also created a device, a pendulum hanging by a special thread, or a metal ball hanging by a thread, which he holds. He went around the students. Swami asked him to interact with the students. So he went around with the students. This pendulum can measure the aura of a person.
Oh, wow.
By swinging away from the person. Uh-huh. He says, when he shared with us outside afterwards, that he stood in darshan in Prashantalayam. Swami was giving darshan. Mm. He stood near the East Prashanti where the students stay, East Prashanti, mm-hmm. quite far away.
Yes.
He said, I held it, the pendulum swung somewhere, just went off.
Amazing.
That is Baba's Amazing. Power. I still remember those days. Whenever Swami used to be in Vrindavan, we used to have Nagar Sankirtan on Thursdays and Sundays. In fact, the students and teachers will go outside. Devotees also, separately, okay. Students separately. We'll go outside for Nagar Sankirtan to Kadugudi or sometimes towards the other side, go to a nearby village, come back. And the reward for that used to be the darshan. As we enter the gate, often we'll find Swami waiting. There used to be a balcony here.
In the old bungalow.
Balcony. Mm. Just below the balcony, there was a door which led to the interview room in those days. Now we see that bridge and the moat here. Mm. That was the interview room there. And above that, in the open terrace, Swami used to come, climb a few steps so that it will be visible to everybody. From the open terrace, he used to give darshan. Mm. And that was something memorable and really treasurable. In the early morning, you can visualize. Yes. Yes. Semi-dark and no lights.
Yes.
And Swami in that glorious
in that aura.
red robe.
Yes.
And so those who were gifted could see that aura around him, flood of light around him.
Mm.
In fact, Baranowski, when he first saw the aura in darshan, he looked around to check whether any halogen light has been displayed on him.
Okay.
It was that very bright.
Wow.
So amazing. That was the beauty of it. I remember my mother used to come after the Nagar Sankirtan darshan. Mm. Hey, did you see that aura? Flood of light. Today it was so much.
Oh, wow.
This was much before the invention of Baranowski, the discovery of Baranowski or the invention of Kirlian photography. There are devotees who are gifted who could see that aura. I was speaking about Narendra, the principal, who met him.
Yes.
I have an interesting story to tell about
Please.
Him. Now, let me present the value of darshan or the meaning of darshan in a different manner.
Sure.
He had just come to Vrindavan first time. He has been a devotee, so he came for darshan. And luckily for him, it was Nagar Sankirtan darshan.
Oh, his first darshan?
First darshan. Nagar Sankirtan darshan in Vrindavan.
Amazing.
Now, when any devotee who was very eager to have darshan, had only one goal, to be as close to Swami as possible.
Yes.
So rush forward, catch the first row.
Yes.
Be in the first row. So he also thought, by being in the first row of this Nagar Sankirtan, actually bhajan singers used to be there. He's almost squeezed through them.
Okay.
He thought he could be right in the front and have Swami's darshan.
See Swami as close as he can.
So he entered the Nagar Sankirtan party, entered from here, was right in the front, excited about having darshan. Swami had just come out. Mm. He came, but to his horror he found, as more and more people from behind, they kept pushing. They also wanted to come in.
Oh, okay.
As they kept pushing, he got pushed and pushed.
Uh-huh.
He was right under the sunshade under the balcony.
Oh.
Under the balcony.
Oh, my God.
Totally hidden from sight.
So when he looks up, there is only the sunshade.
He was facing the wall. Suddenly, he was facing the wall.
Oh, my God.
So he did a wise thing. He wrote an article in a college souvenir. The title of that one is Mirrored in a million eyes.
Mirrored in a million eyes. Oh, wow.
So he writes there, after quoting this, after writing this, he says, I just quietly turned around. I could not see Baba directly, but I see Baba reflected in those thousand eyes before me, hundreds of eyes. Eyes filled with desire, filled with anticipation, worries, and there I could see Baba. These eyes were filled with him and they changed.
Wow.
I think we can say that having darshan is not merely we seeing with our physical eyes.
Yes.
We have to see Bhagwan in the eyes of others.
Wow.
That is seeing Bhagwan in others.
Amazing.
Probably that is also darshan.